Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am your host, Damon Pettit, and this is an actual cigar review. I've been gone, been busy, haven't done a review in a little while now. 3-4 weeks, maybe? Not exactly sure. Today we're doing a Foundry cigar, and this baby here is the Shoreham. Foundry Shoreham, War of Currents, and it's got this cool little band on it right there that obviously will come off. But the name is named after the lab that Nikola Tesla used, and Shoreham. So that's what that is. It is a 54 ring gauge. I believe it's 5.5 inches long. Be more of a very close to a Robusto size, a little bit bigger maybe. And I'm gonna take this, see if I could just slip this little bitch off of here. Yep, there we go. Coming off nice and easy. That's what that's gonna look like. The Foundry cigar, they will not tell you the mixture where the leaves are from, so that's interesting there. Here is the actual thing. It's got a 54 on it for the ring gauge, obviously. Very nicely done. Very interesting how they do it. Let's see what it's like. We're going to just kind of pair it with a coffee that's actually cold. I've had it I poured this coffee probably about an hour and a half ago, so I hope everybody's doing good. I am doing well. So far, very nice draw. I like that. Very dry, very nutty flavor at the right at the quick start there. Very nice draw, very nice flow, very nice. It's got some good smoke coming out of it. It's $8 here, Arizona. At the my tobacconist, I paid $8.25 for it. So 8.25, not bad. At least from everything I've seen, it's not bad. We'll see how it smokes, and more than likely, we'll see if it seems like it's going to hold up and be worth the $8.25. We'll see. Very, I find it very interesting that these, the Foundry cigars, how they're putting this out, making it so that you don't know where the tobacco leaves are from. I mean, they could be from, Kansas for all we know. but we'll, a mystery. And I do like how they are, how it's the War of Currents, and so they have Tesla, and was at war with Edison? Nah, I don't remember. Anyway, Tesla to me was a man way before his time. If we were using his actual stuff right now, I mean, stuff that he did way back in the day, we would not have gas-powered anything. We would not have coal-powered anything. It would be much different right now. about it. There'd be no pollution as far as from any kind of powered vehicles or anything. It would be a whole different world. Right now, if we could take all that suppressed stuff from him, stuff that was taken and probably destroyed or held someplace, but let's say we could take all that, bring it out, and use it right now, we would end poverty, we would end we would level the playing field. It would destroy a lot of things right away, but it would be pretty interesting, and it would be pretty nice to see. But anyway, I'm a pretty big fan of Tesla, and so it's pretty, I picked this cigar because I knew I hadn't smoked it yet, knew I hadn't done any kind of a review on it, and had no idea that was their thinking for this one. So it's pretty cool. I like that. Something that's not cool is my team getting the shit kicked out of them in the Super Bowl. I didn't expect them to win. Thought they might. Knew they could, but did not know what was going to happen. And from the very first play, I've never seen that ever. I don't think. I don't know. I don't know if I've seen. I definitely know it wasn't never a play like that in the Super Bowl, I don't think. Very first offensive play going for the other team. 2 points. So, and then from there, it was just downhill the whole way. Pretty incredible. I still love my team. As far as, you know, if I'm going to root for a team, that's my team. But, I don't know. It was pretty unbelievable. Seattle, they're a very, very tough team. And deserve the win big time. I am glad that my team did at least score. Kept them from at least having the shutout, which I know they wanted. That's the only thing we got. We can say is they didn't shut us out. My ears are cold. It's not very cold out, but my ears are cold. It's probably about 62. So it's very beautiful out, very mild. It's going to be going up and down a little bit from like the high in the 60s to like in about a week. It should be about high in the 80s and then back down into the 60s. So it's going to go, it's supposed to go back and forth a little bit, which is what it usually does. And so when I see all these places where it's snowing really bad or where it's below zero, I was talking to my buddy the other day, Vince, texting back and forth. And it was like, I think it was below zero, and here it was 50s. So I was really glad that I was here. I do not miss the winter times in Colorado or really anywhere. I'm not a huge fan of that. I miss it a little bit every now and then, but not much. Get into a cigar a little, huh? A little bit of like a, it would be, for me, it does remind me of a coffee taste, a little bit of coffee. It got that tinge in there. Remember, if you don't drink coffee, you're not going to probably get a coffee taste out of a cigar. If you eat a lot of licorice or if you eat a lot of some sort of different food, you're going to probably taste that kind of thing more than. And if you've got an extremely well-rounded palate, then you're going to taste probably a whole lot of different things, usually, from a cigar. So, for me, coffee guy, so I will probably pull out some coffee notes in a cigar very often. It's a medium bodied flavor right now. A nice, very nice flavor. It is burning a little off, as you can see. It's not very beautiful. The wrapper looks really nice. It's pretty decent there, not too bad. Kind of a thick burn line, but the ash is not holding real well. I'm just sitting here, there is no wind at all. But it's kind of coming apart a little bit. So we'll see how that holds up, see if it gets stronger. I'm really tired right now for some reason. See if I can put this on as a ring. Not that one. Could fit it on there. Put it on there. I could actually fit it on my ring fingers, but not the other one. Out my thumb. Oh no. Just kidding. I would never wear this as a ring. Just in case Foundry people were wondering. Oh, I wonder if he's going to wear it. I'm sure somebody probably will. I bet you there will be somebody out there. Somebody will probably give it to somebody as a wedding ring. That'd be a sad thing. Unless it meant something, you know, there was some meaning, then it's okay. But as far as, like, to put it on your cigars and stuff like that, very, pretty. I like those different ideas, those different thoughts. So much better than bullshit marketing where they make cutesy words and little sayings, you know, from sayings that are already out there. They make their own saying out of a well-known saying. It just really, that kind of crap bothers me really bad. No imagination, no thought. These people at least put thought into it. It's not like the most beautiful looking, but it's very, that it all kind of has meaning, and I really like the meaning crap. I really do. Still very nice draw. It's got a good medium-bodied flavor, mild medium. It's not very strong. It's kind of what I wanted today, so that's kind of perfect. So his dog has got a problem. The place that I live, it's a nice apartment thing. But they have a Starbucks center, a Starbucks coffee deal. And so you can go and you can just mix the coffee, and you make yourself a coffee. It's free all the time. I could have 100 coffees probably if I could overdo it, I know. But I usually have about 3 a week or so, something like that, depending, maybe one after dinner. Walk on down, have one. This is one I had. And I didn't finish it, so I figured I'd bring it out here. And enjoy it a little bit. I have some wine later, just relax. Tell you what, so far, decent year so far. I hope everybody's doing well. It's February. Always weird news, you know, about the Olympics starting. I'm really not at all into the Olympics. I'm not at all. I would not want to, if I was a member of the press and they said, well, you're going to Sochi, I'd say, well, you're wrong. I'm going home. I would not do it. Just too much bullshit this time, I think. I know we're not supposed to let the the terrorists, you know. If you stop you from going, they already win. Well, sorry. First of all, the Olympics probably shouldn't have even been held there. Not because of any kind of terroristic threat, but because it's one of the warmest parts of that freaking region. And they had that man-made snow. What the hell is that? You know, if you're going to do the Winter Olympics, have it be a place where there's actually winter. Very, very interesting that they chose that. Only part of the Winter Olympics that I used to watch would be the downhill skiing, like the really fast crap. And it was the guy's name who went off the course, came back on. Is it Billy something? I can't remember now. That guy's pretty crazy. Pretty cool. I remember that. But other than that, you know, see some figure skating. It's really not into the Olympics. Really not a sporty guy anymore. And I'm gonna not be an NFL guy here pretty soon with all the crap that they keep changing. They're looking, I can't even get into that. Anyway, football's over this year, so I'm gonna just shut up about it for now and just talk about other things, huh? Just talk about cigars. I know there's a lot of people out there very busy, their different lives with their babies, with their literal children. I have a child in my house, but it's not mine. But I cherish the little guy, so I spend a lot of time with him, and it's fun. So I understand how I don't know how parents have time to do anything but just take care of the little kids, you know. I don't know how people have more than one. I don't know how that all works out. I really don't. I've, you know, I'm a certain age now, and I probably will never have a child myself, as far as I can tell. I don't plan on it. But, it's a very interesting little process, how life is, you know, so fragile, you know, a little human baby can't even hold their head up at first, and then all of a sudden they're holding their head up, then they need to be able to roll over, and they start rolling over, and they start waddling, and then they start crawling a little bit, then all of a sudden they're walking, and pretty soon they're, you know, doing what I'm doing. So, life is pretty incredible. And for all those that have children and stuff, and have grown children or have little children, I hope that they're all very healthy and things are good, because I could see how it would be unbelievably devastating to lose a child. That would be very hard. It would be a hard lesson in life, I think. And so, I don't know. It's burning okay. It's not too bad. It's not horrible. It's not perfect. Still medium body, pretty standard. It's nothing this unbelievable flavor coming out of it or anything. It's very close to like a nut flavor for me. I have a couple people that are in the hot tub area. One's a guy, the other's a girl. Anyway, probably married, so I'm not gonna look over there too much. Okay, that's it. done. Anyway, sorry, it's distracting. I have not ridden my bike in about a month. For a while, it was pretty damn chilly. And then after that, I did get sick. And then, and that was right after we moved. So I think I've only ridden one time so far since, I've only ridden here to work one time since I've moved, which is pretty crazy. So it's been a little while, but I'm going to be getting back on the bike on Tuesday, and that's not going to be easy since I've been off for a little bit, but it'll be good to get back on the horse, so to speak. Coffee tastes good still. I hear people meandering around, which is fine. I'm in this little pit area. It's like a barbecue area. There's a barbecue over this way. A double barbecue. They're gas grills, and then like a bar thing over here. It's got a refrigerator, and then seats over here. There's a few tables with seats right here. A couple TVs right up in here. Not too bad. And it's all outside. And of course, it's like a gazebo type thing. Of course, it's permanent, but I am sore though, which is pretty crazy. Haven't I've done a lot of stretching and push-ups. I have an app on my phone. It's the Extreme Push-Up app. And it's not easy. I've had to do a lot of push-ups on my knees because I get so hard that I start to shake. It's pretty crazy. But it's good for me. What are you doing? You doing anything? I know a lot of people don't like to work out. A lot of people do like to work out. It's all preference and kind of how you grow up, I think. But I am thinking of going, in case you wondered. I'm sure you don't give a fuck, but I was thinking of going to, homeopathy or whatever, and have some work done that way. I think kind of get my body a little bit better shape without using drugs and crap like that. Really not into destroying my body just to make it feel better. I can heal it naturally and stuff like that. Beautiful day here in Arizona. I don't know where you are. I know there's people all over the world actually that end up seeing this every now and then. It's a dog. And thank you very much for watching. I really do appreciate it. It's enjoyable to know that me hanging out, talking, smoking a cigar is enjoyable for more than just myself. Because I know how it is, because like when I'm smoking and I'm not doing a review, I'll pull out other people's reviews and I'll watch them. And so that's the reason why I try to do one a week at least, because I know when I go to hopefully see somebody's new review and there's not one there, it's a little disappointing. So if you happen to watch my stuff every now and then, again, very much appreciate it. It's, I like to try to be there for you. I've got quite a few, 100 and what? I don't know what this is going to be now, 150, 160, I don't know. I'll have to look. It's only 8:30. That's pretty nice. Out here kind of early. Cigars, I push the ash off of it, but it's burning okay. It tastes good. It tastes nice. What was I coming on here? Oh, I wanted to see if I could see what my, I want to see how many reviews or videos I've done. In case you hear other people, that I'm not on this earth alone, so there will be other people around every now and then. Wow, what's that? Okay. Sometimes I see things, it's like, oh, that's just no good. Let's take a look. Gotta go to my uploads. So this is going to be number 163. The last one I did was... It doesn't show when I did it. What the hell? I'm not going to watch it. I want to see how long it's been. December 30th. Jesus Christ, really? Wow. Been over a month. Well, I apologize to anybody who hopes to have a little company. Hopefully you've been able to go back to a few of my older ones. One thing I am going to do is really start going. I'm still going to have them on on YouTube, obviously. I mean, that would be stupid to get rid of them, but I really want to, I have to make my website be the actual hub of where to go. You can, like I said, it'll always be on YouTube, but if I decide to have music or something like that, very possible that YouTube will block it from certain countries or whatever. So always, you can always go to CigarReviewTV.com and, see my latest reviews there, and I need to be able to import all of them, all 162 of them, in there so that they'll all be available that way. Not the easiest thing to do, but it's something I want to do because there's so many of the ones on YouTube that are blocked or whatever else because I have background music. I don't know. It really irritates me, especially when they're are people that have entire movies on there, and I know they don't have the rights to the movie, so I don't know how that all works out, but anyway. Sorry. I inhaled. You know what, like, if I laid my head down and closed my eyes for 5 minutes, I'd fall asleep. I'm just a little bit mentally worn today. Just mentally worn. Sometimes I would really like to just be able to remove my head and put it one side and let the rest of me walk around because my body has energy, but my head does not. I think it would be a little bit freaky for people, you know. I'm really glad I brought that coffee with me. The other couple times I've come out here, I haven't had anything with me to drink. This will be probably a way I do it a lot of times now. Now, when it starts to be warmer, there's going to be people out here, so I'm going to probably be going elsewhere. Because I don't want it to be too noisy and too have people all over me. You know, it's a little bit nuts. trying to think of some new. Well, there's been a lot of. Obviously, it's been a fucking month since I've done. I can't believe it's been over a month. I'm very ashamed of myself. Some people have died. Philip Seymour Hoffman just died. His overdose. And if you are at all struggling with addiction, don't even take a sip of alcohol, you know? I mean, and I'm not being a, like, preacher here. I'm just saying that this, that's kind of what happened to him, is he sober for 23 years. And people that are close to him or whatever said that what kind of kick-started his whole falling off the wagon or whatever it is. He had a drink after they had finished filming one of his films. And this was in 2012. And it just spiraled from there. And just like something so simple, you know? And he did so good. It's just, it's sad. But it's kind of the path that we all walk is different, you know? And we're here to learn something, and when it's over, it is. So, who knows when my little path will end. Hopefully not for another, I don't know, maybe 60 years? Then again, I might be ready to go on 20, we never know. But, you know, death is not something I'm afraid of, not something I don't want to die right now. But I believe death is not a terrible thing for the person that actually passes, that goes on. Because I'm not an atheist. I believe that there's something other than right here. Completely different vibration and everything. So it's just for all of us left behind, it's a little bit sad. This ear is so cold. Oh, wow. I know I have a hoodie, but I don't want to look like a hoodlum smoking a cigar. Yeah, it's looking pretty crappy. But it's smoking nice. It's got a very nice draw. Decent little flavor. Nothing special, but nothing worth $8.25 for the size of the cigar, for the limit. I'm not sure if this is like one of their limited ones or not, but if we're going to keep making these, however that goes. But it's really border. Hello. Hi there. I knew that was going to happen at some point. Get through the smoke. What was I saying? Oh, it's borderline worth being $8.25. If you want to try something new, if you don't want something with really bold, you know, something that's going to knock you in the face, this is a decent cigar. It's worth a try. It's not bad at all. The draw itself is nice. I'm having a nice time with it. If I was hanging out with friends and stuff, I'd be happy with it. If I was on a golf course, I might not be so happy with it because of, you know, more than likely it would give me some problems out wandering about, sitting, hanging out. This cigar is okay. I don't know if they're all smoked the same way. But it might be worth a try. I'd give it a go ahead. Go ahead and give this bitch a try. And if you see a deal on one, grab it. If you got 8 1/4 to spend on it, go ahead and grab it. if you want to try one of the other thousands of cigars out there, by all means. But it's good to be back here and doing another one. Be doing another one next week at some point. Sounds like they're here to get me. I'm joking. Nobody's looking for me. It sounds like a ambulance anyway. You know what? Actually, I don't know what that is. Well, everybody. It's been a good time. I hope you're having a good day. I hope you're smoking a good cigar. I hope you're enjoying the weather, whether it's snowing or sunny, whether you're in Hawaii or Alaska, the Philippines, Japan, wherever you are. I hope you're doing well, and I hope life is treating you well. And thank you very much for watching. I really do appreciate it. It's a good time for me. I enjoy doing it. And so if you enjoy watching it, that's a gift for me. Really appreciate it. So don't forget, you can go to cigarreviewtv.com. You can see me on Twitter. I don't tweet a whole lot. I probably want to try to get back into some tweeting and stuff, but honestly, I just back and forth a little bit. I read some tweets and stuff here and there, and just I don't know, people use it a lot for their own advertising, you know, for plugging their stuff all the time and stuff like that, instead of just saying, hey, what the fuck, how you doing, I'm having ice cream, I'm taking a crap, whatever. I don't want to see ads all the time, that's all. Anyway, so go to my website if you like, cigarreviewtv.com. You can hang out there a little bit. You can contact me there if you like. You can always send me an email if you want to, which is damon@cigarreviewtv.com. Made that up all by myself. So, everybody have a fantastic day, week, weekend, night, Christmas, whatever day it is, Halloween, Easter, Thursday. Whatever it is, just have a good one. Enjoy. Thank you again, from the inside of me to you. Thank you very much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And I look forward to smoking with you again very soon. Take care, bud.